Yeah, I was just gonna say, man, they're probably on all the drugs back in those days, bro. I think it's like the 90s too, bro, like easily. This is crazy, man, because, like, yo, if you don't know the pathway, like, I feel like something can just catch your head while you're just riding through that place, bro. And, like, you probably have to be, like, super professional to, like, do that. Bro, imagine trying to, like, shower all that off afterwards, bro. It'd probably take you, like, 2 days to, like, get every piece of mud off of you, bro. It's probably all up in your mouth and everything, like, yo. And these guys are just laughing, bro. It's just like, man.
Crazy. This is why Steph Curry and the Warriors are gonna win. I ain't gonna lie to you. This is why I love the Warriors and Steph Curry. It's not because, yes, they play good. Yes, you know, Curry's the goal. But look how they put God first, bro. Not only the players, but the whole arena. They're inviting people to worship. I think they sponsor this worship team. Not a lot of teams do this. Who's doing this NBA? Who's doing this in sports in general? What? Look. People. I gotta hear this again. I'm sorry, y'all. Hear this, bro. Come on.
This brings me back to those days, bro. Getting up early in the morning to go to church, bro. And this is kind of crazy. I did not know this was, like, happening, you know what I mean, in any arena. But I'm not surprised with, like, Steph Curry. He is a pretty religious guy and his whole family, so. Not surprised, man. That's kind of cool. I'm not gonna lie to you, bro. If, like, that's something I would do if I was building my, like, dream house or whatever. Like, this is something that I would do too, bro. It's actually pretty cool though. It probably took a while for him to make that too. That's kind of cool, man. I don't know.
That's what I'm talking about.
Kind of looks like Tom Green a little bit. I thought it was him for just a second. I was like, what the hell is that, Tom Green?
If this wasn't recorded, no one would believe it.
Definitely not a professional league, that's for sure. How do you not get knocked out after that, bro? Oh, why are they squaring up like that? They're like dancing. Bro, what? Bro, they do it at the same time? Like, why'd that look like a dance move, bro?
It's a dishwasher. It's General Electric's convertible dishwasher with power scrub that will clean pots, pans, and even casseroles. Your utensils, even the crusty ones, come out shiny and clean from GE.
And Kelly, I'd like to have your bid on that dishwasher.
$250.
$250. Dale, what do you say?
$190.
$190. And?
$240.
$240 is Ann's bid, and that brings us to you, Valerie.
Higher. $179.
$179. Is that your bid? Okay, we have four bids. The actual retail price of the dishwasher is $250, and Calais.
I'm not gonna lie though, I watched this show a lot, like back when I was like a little kid, bro. Man, like it brings back a lot of memories, man, with like the music and stuff.
So I did.
You screamed, but I mean there's a group of people back there.
Yeah, my mother's there, my son and his friend.
Well, good for them. Now we are right here in the middle of the new Price is Right supermarket. And Janice here is going to ring up your purchases. Now, what are you going to purchase? You're going to purchase these five items that you see here on this counter. Now, I want you to look these items over carefully as Johnny Olson describes them in detail.
Little Friskies, the balanced diet for all cats, appetizing for the pet, easy to use for the owner.
It's kind of crazy, like, it's so much different now. And it's a really cool how the show is still going on till this day. Like, it's 2024. This is 1972, bro. Like, they're still doing episodes till this day. I think with, like, Drew Carey or I think it's Drew Carey as the host now. It's crazy, man.
Those new taste fans, kick them on.
Still going strong. Whoa, what? How did he change his face to that? Like a cartoon character. Hey! Not bad. That's a good prank, bro. I like that one.
We're so gallantly streaming.
Oh my god. She might have done better than Fergie, I'm not gonna lie, bro.
Can a person who has been frozen for 56 years be revived? In
bro,
simple terms,
what?
It involves freezing a terminally ill person and then thawing them out when a cure is available. Can this really lead to revival? The first person to be frozen was American physicist James Bedford in 1967. What has happened since then? Of course. The freezing process is not as simple as putting something in a refrigerator. The body contains a lot of water, and if it is frozen directly, the water will form deadly ice crystals that pierce cells and organs, causing irreversible damage. However, scientists have long since overcomed this challenge. They drained Bedford's blood and injected a biological antifreeze to ensure that the body and organs are not damaged by freezing. After naturally cooling to a certain temperature, Bedford's body was placed in liquid nitrogen at 196 degrees and positioned upside down. This procedure is truly baffling, and it marks the beginning of his ordeal. It is worth mentioning that there are already several hundred frozen people around the world waiting to be thawed and revived when medical technology advances.
Really?
However, unfortunately, despite 56 years of the invention of cryonics, certain diseases such as cancer remain unconquered. The few hundred cases of frozen individuals remain in limbo. Some people believe that even if they are thawed, they will not survive, which would violate the laws of nature. Others think that cryonics is just a money-making scheme, given the exorbitant cost and the decades-long wait. If this technology were to succeed, would you dare to give it a try?
I'm not gonna lie, that was a cool clip, like how you can freeze your body and like preserve it for the future, but that AI voice was killing me, bro. Like, the way he was pronouncing the words, bro. Like, what the hell?
First up are the walking trees in Azerbaijan, which honestly look like giant carrots growing in the sky. But in reality, this place doesn't really exist and is completely animated. Next up is the Lake Abraham in Canada, which is fully covered in white circles in winter. And in reality, that's actually real and looks absolutely amazing, so I can definitely recommend you to visit it. Following is the famous city Venice in Italy, which is well known for its beautiful canals and amazing opportunities to drive boats. But in reality, Venice is often flooded and is completely full with tourists. But besides that, this place is very beautiful. Thereafter is Lake Powell, which is the perfect spot to take an amazing ride through. And in reality, this lake is very cool, but the mountains around it look completely different. And lastly is the Colosseum in Rome, which is probably one of the most famous buildings that ever existed on Earth. And in reality, this place is actually incredible and worth a visit. But be aware that this place is also always...
That's how it is, though. A lot of people will, like, do edits to their videos and their pictures and make places seem way crazier than they actually are. Like, I've noticed that trend, bro. See, like, videos like this are kind of hard to, like, believe in just because a lot of the pictures they show you, like, space pictures, pictures of, like, the Earth, like, other planets, they're all fake. And, like, the scientists that come out, NASA, they actually admit that they're all fake, too. Like, a lot of scientists will say that. So it's kind of hard to believe what the planet is actually. You know what I mean? This could all just be, like, a bunch of made-up nonsense just for entertainment, right? But, like, based off the studies, this is how the planet Uranus is supposed to sound like. Yeah. But, I don't know, man. I'm thinking that the planet would be way more vicious than, like, how it's being displayed in this video. I feel like the second you come even near it, like, you're gonna get, like, destroyed in some sort of way. Yeah, man, some advertisements are pretty crazy, man, especially when companies put a lot of money into it to make it look like legit. Some of these are pretty sick, though. Yeah, McDonald's, they got the money to do that, though. I think the Simpsons one was the best one. Bro, this guy is definitely smoking crack or something, bro. Like, that definitely wasn't cigarettes. That's pretty dope. Pretty sure it's from the painting.
Hey, seriously, is this safe?
50-50.
50-50, what, like 50% we live, 50% we die?
50-50. Bro, what the?
Nah, bro. Trip's over. How do you even stand like that? Like, yo, it takes skill to, like, being able to stand like that, yo. Like, your feet position for a long period of time, bro. Like, man, looks like a straight-up statue. That's such a trip. And it's just the person with the cameras moving. Like, that house is stationary. It's just all an optical illusion, bro. Like, new mixtape coming up, guys. The internet, May 14th, April 20th. You'll be able to purchase it and listen to it before everyone else. May 14th, it'll be available on all platforms. So I'll give you guys the information on how to purchase it, the pricing, and, you know, all that good stuff. Once we get closer to April 20th, then I will give you that information. Just subscribe, keep viewing, keep liking the videos. I'm telling you, man, this is going to be a good year. Once again, I'm Looper Norris. Thanks again for watching, guys. I'm out of here, man. Peace.